Here is some information about breast cancer from Breast Cancer Now. Some key facts that you need to know about breast cancer. Breast cancer is the most common cancer in women in the UK. Around 55,000 women and 370 men are diagnosed with breast cancer every year. One in seven women in the UK will develop breast cancer in their lifetime. About your breasts. Breasts are made up of lobules, milk-producing glands, and ducts, tubes that carry milk to the nipple. These are surrounded by glandular, fibrous, and fatty breast tissue that give the breasts their size and shape. When checking your breasts, this is what you can often feel. Breasts also contain a network of thin tubes called lymph vessels. These are connected to the lymph nodes or glands under the arm. What is breast cancer? Breast cancer starts when cells in the breast begin to divide and grow in an abnormal and uncontrolled way. Breast cancer isn't one single disease, there are several types. Breast cancer can be non-invasive, also called in situ, or invasive. Non-invasive breast cancer is when cancer cells haven't yet developed the ability to spread within the breast or to another part of the body. Primary or invasive breast cancer is when cancer cells have spread to the surrounding breast tissue but haven't spread beyond the breast or the lymph nodes under the arms. Secondary or metastatic breast cancer is when breast cancer cells have spread from the breast through the lymph nodes or the bloodstream to other parts of the body. This is most commonly seen in the bones, liver, lung, or brain. Breast awareness. Being breast aware means getting to know how your breasts look and feel, so you know what's normal for you. It's about knowing what new or unusual changes to look and feel for and having the confidence to report them to your GP. It's important to remember that breasts will change throughout someone's life. This happens through puberty, during the menstrual cycle, in pregnancy, and the menopause. Why is early detection important? The sooner breast cancer is diagnosed, the more successful treatment is likely to be. Most cases are found by women noticing unusual changes and visiting their GP to get them checked out. So it's really important for all adult women to be breast aware. Checking your breasts only takes a few minutes, and it's as easy as TLC. Touch, look, check. Touch, look, check. Touch your breasts. Can you feel anything unusual? Look for changes. Does anything look different? Check any changes with your GP. There's no special technique. Check the whole breast area, including your armpits, your upper chest, and up to your collarbone. If you get into the habit of checking them as part of your usual routine, you won't need to worry about whether you're doing it often enough. A good time to check might be when you're in the bath or shower, using body lotion, or getting dressed. It's about finding a time and way that suits you. Signs and symptoms. Most breast changes, including lumps, won't be breast cancer, but it's important to get any new or unusual changes checked out by your doctor. Signs and symptoms of breast cancer include a lump or swelling in the breast, upper chest, or armpit, a change to the skin, such as puckering or dimpling, a change in the colour of the breast, it may look red or inflamed, a nipple change, for example, it has become pulled in or inverted when it usually points out, rash or crusting around the nipple, unusual liquid or discharge from either nipple, changes in size or shape of the breast. On its own, pain in your breasts is not usually a sign of breast cancer, but look out for pain in your breast or armpit that's there all or almost all the time. While breast cancer in men is rare, they do have a small amount of breast tissue where cancer cells can develop, so we recommend that adult men should be body aware. Routine NHS breast screenings. Breast screening uses an X-ray called a mammogram to look for breast cancers that may be too small to see or feel. Everyone aged 50 to 70 who is registered as female with their GP is automatically invited to breast screening. Invitations are sent by letter. This may not happen the year they turn 50, but it will happen by the time they're 53. Between mammograms, it's important for people to keep being breast aware and check their breasts regularly. What causes breast cancer? Many things affect our chance of developing breast cancer. Some of these things we can't change. For example, being female. 99% of new cases are in women. Age is also a factor, as our risk increases as we get older. 8 out of 10 cases are diagnosed in women aged 50 and over. Around 2,300 per year are diagnosed in women aged 39 or under. That's 4% of all cases. Family history is important too. Around 5% of women with breast cancer have inherited a gene that increases their risk of developing it. Lifestyle can play a part as well. It's estimated at least 23% of breast cancer cases could be prevented, as they're related to lifestyle behaviours. Stay active. You can help to reduce your chances of developing breast cancer by being physically active on a regular basis. The UK's chief medical officers recommend adults do at least 150 minutes of physical activity a week. You can divide this up however you like. It could be 20 minutes a day or 30 minutes five times a week, whatever works for you. Keeping to a healthy weight. Keeping to a healthy weight can lower your chance of getting breast cancer. After the menopause, women's risk of breast cancer increases if they're overweight. The more weight you gain in your life, the higher your risk will be. Being drink aware. Regularly drinking alcohol is associated with a higher risk of developing breast cancer. The more you drink, the greater the risk. National health guidelines recommend that men and women drink no more than 14 units of alcohol a week. That's the equivalent of 6 175 milliliter glasses of wine or 6 pints of lower strength beer a week. You should also spread your drinks over a few days and aim to have days off drinking each week. To find out more about breast cancer and breast health, you can visit our website, follow us on social media, or call our free helpline. Thank you for listening.